In this video, I'll show you an example of custom PI data archive security in action and how all our users are individually getting the tailored access that they need. So in this demo, we have different user groups at the company. And these groups are, for example, PI administrators, our process engineering leads, who manage all of the process engineers, and also everyone at our company, all company employees. And finally, we have some external consultants. Now, all these different user groups, they have different needs when it comes to how they interact with the PI Data Archive. For example, our PI administrators need to be able to do absolutely everything. Now, our process engineering leads, first, they need to be able to see all the data, but they're also responsible for some of the configuration. They create new PI points and PI interfaces that are related to our process, as well as do any edits to some existing ones. And if there's a problem, they'll want to be able to check our PI Data Archive system configuration and health to help determine what the issue is. While the process engineering leads make the configuration choices for the process data collection, our process engineers are still involved with the PI system. And so, in addition to being able to see the data, they do still also want to be able to check the system configuration and health. And finally, at our company, all of the employees do have access to see all the data in our PI system, make it easy to share the data. However, our external consultants, they're just helping us troubleshoot our particular asset that we're having issues with, our pump 5. So they'll only need to see the data for pump 5. I have already created custom identities that map to these Windows groups and granted the specific permissions that they need on the database security and PI points. Let's check out the end result. The first thing let's check is confirming that all the employees at our company can see the data for all of our PI points, but the consultants can only see data for the pump 5 ones. Here we're logged in with Isaac, who's part of our all company group. Now, Isaac typically works with PI Data Link to consume data. And when Isaac does a search in PI Data Link, let's see the number of PI points Isaac can find. Down here at the bottom, we can see that Isaac can see all 116 of the PI points at our company. And we know that he can see the data when we hover over and see the values, just like this. Let's compare this to the results that one of our consultants would see. Connecting here with Sarah, Sarah is in part of the consultants group, and she also works with Excel. When she does a search for the PI points, however, she's going to get some different results. She can only see the PI points that are specifically for pump 5 and a test PI point that everyone is able to work with. Similarly, she can see the data for these PI points in addition to being able to find them. With this, we've confirmed that while everyone at our company can see data for the PI points, our consultants can only see the data for the PI points that they're meant to. In addition to data, what about some of the system checks, checking the configuration of our PI Data Archive? Let's go back to Isaac. In addition to looking at data in the client tools, let's take a look at some of the PI system management tool functionality. Isaac is a business user, and he doesn't work with the Pi system. So for example, if he tries to look at the security configuration for the Pi data archive, he won't see anything. The results will show up blank here, in addition to the security error. However, we know that our process engineers are comfortable working with the Pi system and need to be able to check the system health or configuration if there's an issue with the data flow. Let's take a look at what one of our engineers sees. Here we're connected with Matthew, who's part of our process engineering team. When Matthew goes to check the security configuration in PySMT, he's able to see everything. Similarly, he might need to check things like, what are the snapshot and archive statistics? And again, he's able to see the data that he needs about how the Pi system is currently performing. While Matthew is able to see the settings and the health of the Pi data archive, he won't be performing any configuration changes because that's something that the process engineering team leads take care of. For example, if Matthew tried to perform one of their tasks, like creating a new Pi point, he wouldn't be able to. Down here at the bottom, we see that this point was unable to successfully be saved. That's why it's still showing up as blue here. Let's look at the difference when a process engineering lead performs the same action. Here we are with Emma, who's one of our process engineering leads. In Pi System Management Tools, because she's responsible for creating new Pi points and Pi interfaces for the process engineering team, she would be able to perform the actions that Matthew cannot. For example, she was just able to successfully create a new Pi point. Similarly, let's look at when she's configuring new Pi interfaces. Here on our Pi interface node, in Pi interface configuration utility, she could go ahead and set up new Pi interfaces for us. Keep in mind that the new Pi interface configuration is something that we only specifically want our Pi administrators and our process engineering leads to be able to do. If somebody else, like one of the process engineers, tried to do it, this is what they would see. On our Pi interface node, they would be unable to configure new Pi interfaces. As you can see, with this security model, each user group gets just the amount of access that they need, whether that's from seeing specific types of data, seeing specific Pi data archive configuration, or making changes to our Pi data archive. Are you ready to configure tailored permissions like this? Then let's build out the security model together in the following videos.